Hi, I'm Harsha, and I will present our recent work on algorithms and systems for approximate nearest neighbor search at web scale. The interest in ANNS at web scale arises from advances in deep learning that are changing the way we do search and recommendation. To take text search, for example, we are moving away from literal matches to semantic similarity-based matches via embeddings. Embeddings are encodings of objects, such as sentences or words, into points in a geometric space so that objects that are nearby are more likely to be semantically similar. Here's a simple illustration of a few words embedded in a five-dimensional space. And as you can see, the Euclidean distance between the pair of dog and cat is smaller than the less semantically similar pair of dog and car. In the framework of deep learning-based search and recommendation, ANNS is a critical component that serves as the first retrieval layer. Documents in the database, which could be as large as a trillion or more points, are embedded into a large high-dimensional space, which could be hundreds of dimensions. And queries are also embedded into the same space. The first step in answering this query is to identify the top k nearest geometric neighbors to the query. As you know, solving this problem exactly would require an exhaustive linear scan in such high-dimensional space, which is prohibitively expensive at trillion scale. As a result, we settle for approximate methods, which have sublinear time complexity. And we measure recall, which denotes the fraction of candidates output by this algorithm that are in fact the true top k nearest neighbors. There's a rich history of work in this topic and spanning many class of algorithms, including trees, clustering, and hashing. Hashing-based methods are particularly appreciated because they provide a bound on the recall as a function of the time and space complexity. However, in the past few years, graph-based indices have become the empirical state of the art and are now widely deployed in the industry, including Microsoft. There's an active community of researchers who implement and benchmark these algorithms, and here is a comparison of more than a dozen algorithms on a million-point SIFT image descriptor dataset. So what's the problem that we're trying to solve? Note that the comparison in the previous slide used only a million-point dataset. However, there are many web and enterprise-scale scenarios that require indices spanning 100 billion or even trillions of points. Moreover, we need to keep this index up to date with new content. There are also platforms like Outlook and Azure Data Lake, which can yield hundreds of trillions of or more points that could be indexed for semantic search. At this scale, current algorithms have many limitations, two of which are we think are key and are addressed in our current in our research. The first problem is that existing state-of-the-art graph algorithms use in-memory data structures to provide interactive latencies and high throughput. The second problem is that these indices cannot be updated efficiently. In fact, if you do a large sequence of deletes on most graph indices, their recall properties degrades and they become ineffective. As a result, in practice, they're rebuilt from scratch periodically. If you were to try and support a trillion point index at, using current algorithms, we would need tens of thousands of machines to serve the index and also tens of thousands of machines to periodically rebuild this index every 6 to 12 hours. This is not practical at scale, and this prevents the wide deployment of ANNS indices. We address the first problem with the disk scan system. This is the first published ALK system that uses inexpensive SSDs to index 5 to 10 times more point per machine, thus offering a lesser cost of operation, while at the same time offering sub 10 millisecond latencies and high throughputs. We solve the second problem, which is a streaming problem, using the fresh disk scan system, which builds on the disk scan system to provide real-time freshness properties and at the same time allows for thousands of inserts and deletes to take place on the same node which supports the search. Since both these systems are based on graph indices, here's a quick primer on how graph indices work for ANNS. In the pre-processing or index building stage, we build a navigable graph over the points in the data set with a designated start point S. In order to answer a query Q, we start at S and look at the neighbors of S and walk over to the node that is closest to the query, and we repeat this iteration many times greedily until we reach convergence, and we output the local optima. It's been shown that you can, in fact, build graphs so that this fast, greedy search algorithms converges to the right answer most of the times. And this provides high recalls with a low latency. The downside is that the greedy search requires random access patterns, which can only be supported effectively with an in-memory data structure. And as a result, we are limited to about 100 million points per machine, say of 100 dimensions on a machine with a typical machine 128 GB of RAM. To address this problem, we devised a disk scan system that uses inexpensive SSDs to store a new low diameter graph that we've designed and a small amount of memory to store highly compressed vectors. The search we showed in the previous slide is modified to use the compressed vectors to identify the best node to navigate to in each hop. Each hop results in a random SSD I/O, and by designing the graph to minimize the number of hops, we reduce the number of round trips to SSDs, which is in fact the critical bottleneck for performance. Further, when nodes are touched in SSD, we also fetch their full precision vectors, which is useful for re-ranking the results at the end of the greedy search. Here's a latency versus recall plot comparing the performance of Discan with the only other open source billion scale algorithm, Phase. Using just 64 GB of memory and inexpensive off-the-shelf SSDs, we can achieve a recall that is as close to 100% as desired in millisecond latencies. As a result of these accuracy and performance characteristics, Discan is widely used in Bing ads for deep learning-based pipelines and is increasingly being used and explored and deployed in Bing search scenarios. The fresh Discan system builds on these ideas and supports concurrent real-time updates to index with stable recall. Let's first see what this property means. Since ANNS indices typically use randomized algorithms, these indices provide higher recall when configured to expend more effort on search. Now, suppose we have an index D and we modify it by inserting and delete so that we have an index of the same cardinality. We expect the same search complexity to provide the same recall in both the cases. And we would not like for the recall to degrade and go to an inferior operating curve. In fact, in fresh Discan, we designed the first graph index that can be updated to support inserts and deletes with stable recall. And we demonstrate this empirically using many rigorous tests. However, it's still an open problem to prove that this recall can be stable over adversarial sequences of operations. Second, we also built a streaming support based on this graph update rules to support concurrent updates in search. In fact, we can support a user-facing latency of 10 milliseconds for search, of a millisecond for insert, and a few microseconds for deletes. Also, we can support more than 1,000 concurrent inserts, deletes, and queries per second on a single machine, primarily backed by an SSD with a very limited memory footprint, say of 128 GB. While the graph update rules are easy to apply to an in-memory graph, applying them to an SSD resident graph leads to too many small random writes that could choke the bandwidth or even wear out the device. To manifest these devices to SSD efficiently, we need to aggregate recent changes to short-term in-memory data structures that are periodically merged to the long-term index to reflect changes to reflect changes. In fact, the merge is a critical contribution of the fresh Discan system, and it's a two-pass streaming algorithm that can work with a DRAM footprint that's proportional to the number of new points and not the overall size of the index. This allows us to work with indices that are 10 to 20 times larger than the size of the DRAM. Now that we overviewed the Discan and the fresh Discan systems, I would like to close with some potential directions for further research. In terms of functionality, I think it's important to develop indices that can support hybrid queries that are a combination of structured SQL-like queries and ANNS queries. For example, maybe you want to find an email that answers question Q, but from a particular sender S. Second, it's also important to develop graph indices that can support out-of-distribution queries, which tend to come from cross-domain querying systems like text-to-image queries. In terms of reducing cost of operations, I think it's important to develop deep learning models that can work with smaller embeddings. Currently, most embeddings are 100 plus bytes per object, and at 10 to the 14 or 10 to the 15 scales required by some cloud systems, this can be prohibitively expensive. Second, it would also be good to develop models and algorithms that allow for queries to be processed with far fewer random IOs, for example, less than 10 instead of several dozen taken by current systems. This could allow us to shift these workloads from SSDs to even less expensive hard drives. In terms of platforms, we are working on developing algorithms that interoperate with existing platforms like transactional databases like Outlook and open source search engines like Lucene. Thank you, and I'll leave you with two links, one to the open source version of Discan, and also a second link to the NeurIPS 21 competition we are organizing to develop algorithms to encourage development of algorithms at a billion scale. Thank you.